the ice now, the most decorated team in the competition, three-time Russian champions, and the reigning world bronze medalists. Here are Irina Lobacheva and Ilya Averbuch of Russia.
Come on, my heart, come on, my heart. I'm gonna give you a candy.
They're both very good skaters. They have nice lines. They're well matched. Good flow and edgy, similar to Lang and Chernyshev. Now, Tracy, what do the judges go for more? This long line style of skating or the very upbeat, perky, like we just saw? Well, I think personally the most important thing is that the team show good technique. So a team like this, with very good lines, clean skating, we'll get the higher marks. Great use of the waltz position here. You watch while all the footwork is going on, turning within each other's arms, very close together. Unison, very strong. Tracy, Russians have dominated ice dancing, and yet we go into an Olympic year and the list of favorites for the gold does not include a Russian team, so the pressure on them is enormous.
Yes, it is.
Trying to carry on the Russian tradition, but this is a fine team. There's a lot of great ice dance teams in the field this Olympic year. Russian champions Irina Lobacheva and Ilya Averbuch will be back with their scores in just a moment. We're back in Brisbane. Irina Lobacheva, Ilya Averbuch of Russia, and their coach Natalia Linenchuk waiting for the first set of scores. Original dance, and by far the highest we've seen. 5.6 all the way up to 5.9. Presentation marks we can expect will be equally strong. And yes, they are 5.8 and 5.9. So that is easily enough to put Irina Lobacheva and Ilya Averbuch into first place after the short program.